Calculating the calendar mentally. Learning the sequence of days 1 to 31. The first thing we need to learn to mentally calculate the calendar is learning the sequence of the days in vertical order. It will allow us to reach all weeks of the month fast for any day. Will also allow us to obtain all the day numbers for every weekday. The only other thing that we must never forget is the weekday name in which the month starts, and also the number of days in that month. We simply must memorize that, and normally it's enough to memorize it for the current month. Over time it will become more routinary to remember those details. We have months with 28, 29, 30 and 31 days, but if we learn the sequence for 31 days we can calculate any day of shorter months. The following is the verbal sequence we need to learn. A single line is the sequence for a single weekday. The month can start at any day. So the sequence for day 1 or the rest of these sequences can fall at any weekday name 1, 8, 15, 22, 29, 2, 9, 16, 23, 30, 3, 10, 17, 24, 31, 4, 11, 18, 25, 5, 12, 19, 26, 6, 13, 20, 27, 7, 14, 21, 28. Just memorize the previous numbers and see if you can inspect the calendar for the current month and match this sequence with the sequence for the actual month that you are interested in. There are only 7 weekdays, so this list can only start in 7 different ways, but this same sequence is used for all 7 combinations. Now see if you can't determine the first day of the week without looking at the calendar as well as the last day. Practice with other days as you need them. Determining the last day. We have months with 28, 29, 30 and 31 days. 28-day months end the weekday before they started. 29-day months end the same weekday in which they started. 30-day months end the next weekday from which they started. 31-day months end to weekdays after the one in which they started. The first day of the following month is simply the very next weekday for any of the last weekdays we just described. Now see if you can't calculate the last weekday for this month and then the first weekday for the next month by advancing to the following weekday. Now also try to calculate the weekday of several birthdays or deadline weekdays for when you need to finish or pay something. Also try to calculate the weekdays for the next Saturday and Sunday.